humorous chapter, including irony and some of the points. If we talk about the marriage of the narrator, that he wanted to marry a fat woman, and the reason, you know why he wanted to marry a fat woman, but ultimately what has happened, he ended up in marrying a lean, thin woman who is endowed with the quality of a stranger, right? And maybe this chapter, it was related to his experience. He has encountered a cobra snake, and the snake, because he was living in a rented apartment where he was sharing the room with the rats. So it was just because of that, number of rats were found there. So one day, a cobra entered and came from the ground. And he his lap, finally, was wriggling and slithered onto his left arm and squeezing it with the lap of like of a pellet rod. And finally, it came into its lap and finally it sat in front of the mirror. And see, during that time also, when the snake was sitting in front of the mirror, in spite of being afraid, he was thinking humorously that what the snake is thinking of. He thought that the snake is thinking of putting a mascara or eyeliner or putting a vermilion sign on its forehead. And finally, it's just his luck only that the snake left from that place. As soon as the snake has moved onto the table, he has immediately ran from that room. Again, adding to his bad luck, what was that? That the thieves, they have entered to his room on that day. And finally, what has happened? They have taken all the essential things and leaving some of the things for him. That was really very bad for him. And this was his experience. This is the chapter, The Snake and the Mirror, we have read. So now coming up to the question answers. So the first question that you can see on your book is, the sound was a familiar one. What sound did the doctor hear? And what did he think it was? Yes, what was the familiar sound? Give the answer.
The doctor lived in a rented apartment. Therefore, there were many rats.
Yes.
It was infested by many rats.
He was
He
was hearing the chittering sound of the rats, and ultimately he thought that this sound usually comes, and this is the reason why he said so, that it was a familiar one. And what did he think it was? Of course, he thought that because number of rats were found there, so ultimately he thought that this sound was that of the rats only. Okay. Now, how many times did he hear it? Find the places in the text. How many times did he hear it?
He heard this
he
sound,
heard this sound
times.
Three times.
He had heard this sound. Can you explain the where these are mentioned in the chapter?
Again came that noise from above.
Again, I heard. Okay, it was mentioned. Yes, take out the, you can say, lines from the chapter. See, paragraph number 4, the last line. Again, I heard that sound from above. Okay?
Again.
Yes.
And paragraph again, 1.
Phrases are, again, I heard that sound from above. Again okay. Came the noise from above. Suddenly, okay, right. A dull thud, as if a rubber tube has fallen.
Suddenly, there came a dull thud. Okay, this is another one, right? Okay, so you can also include it here. Fine. So it means that 3 times he has heard that noise which was coming from above. Okay, so next coming up to the question, when and why did the sound stop? When and why did the sound stop?
The sound stopped after the
sound stopped when the snake appeared.
It stopped when the snake fell down because it had reached the floor.
When the rats, they must have seen the snake. At that time, all the rats, they must have been, they have, you can say, they have receded back to their holes. And ultimately, at that time, what has happened? That sound, it stopped. Okay? The sound, it stopped. And ultimately, that was actually the sound of what? Actually, it was the sound of a sound of the snake falling from the roof. Next, after that, second question, what two important and earth-shaking decisions did the doctor take while he was looking into the mirror? So what two important and earth-shaking decisions the narrator has taken? So what were those two decisions that he has taken?
The doctor made quiet
daily.
That?
He would shave daily.
He would shave daily and grow a mustache in order to look more handsome.
He was unmarried. Okay. And he will wear a smile.
He would always keep that attractive smile on his face.
And yes. Okay. And he will also marry. These are the three earth-shaking decisions, important decisions that he has taken while admiring his beauty in front of the mirror. So the next question is, I looked into the mirror and smiled, says the doctor. A little later he says, I forgot my danger and smiled feebly at myself. What is the doctor's opinion about himself when he first smiles, then second time when he smiles again? So what are the two times when he smiled?
After looking in the mirror, he smiles because he was attracted by himself. He appreciated his beauty and made some important decisions.
At first time, he was admiring his beauty.
He smiled at his image whenever he looked into the large mirror.
Right. He was looking into the mirror. And at that time, being a bachelor, he thought that he should always wear a smile on his face so that he should look beautiful. Okay. And moreover, what he has thought, that he will also grow a mustache and always wear a smile in order to get married and in order to find a perfect match for himself. And the second time when he smiled,
he laughed at his destiny. Second time.
When he laughed?
His life was in danger.
When he was, when the snake, it has curled around its body and it was curling around its left arm, at that time he also laughed. Actually, it means that at first time it was an appreciative smile. He was admiring his beauty, right? But second time, what kind of smile it was? But the second time it was a smile of what? It was a smile of fear. He was smiling feebly, weakly, right? Okay. So it means that his smile of happiness, it has turned up into a smile of fear and to be frightened. Okay. Now, the story about a frightening incident is indicated in a humorous way. So what makes it humorous? Now think of the contrast it present between the dreams and reality. Yes, this will be helpful in formulating, in finding out the actual facts, what the narrator or what the writer wants to deliver to us. So first is the kind of person the doctor is, money and possessions. So what kind of person? He was a doctor. He has started his career in a rented room and which was not up to the mark. There were a number of rats in the room, but actually what he wanted to marry a woman who would be sound enough, who would have good medical practice, along with that lot of money. Okay. And he also wanted to get money after getting married. So there is a contrast between his situation, that what he actually was, and his real situation. Okay. Next. The kind of person he wants to be, what kind of person? He's not so good looking, but what kind of person he wants to be? He wanted to be beautiful. For that, he has taken three main decisions, that he will grow a mustache, will always wear a smile on his face, right? Second, the person he wants to marry and the person he actually marries. So what kind of person he wants to marry?
He intends to marry a woman doctor who has plenty of money.
Yes.
And good medical practice.
With good medical practice. And what kind of woman he has married?
A skinny woman who is
a thin, really
good sprinter.
Yes, but he has married a woman who is what? Who is
a good
thin, lean, good and she was
thin,
also endowed with the quality of sprinter. Actually, why he wanted to marry a fat woman? So that if he would commit a silly mistake, the woman would not run after him. Okay, but actually what has happened? It was not his wish to be fulfilled. He married a woman. What kind of woman? Who was thin and lean.
Thin.
Next. His thoughts when he looks into the mirror and his thoughts when the snake is coiled around his arm. So what were his thoughts at two different points?
By looking in the mirror, he was attracted to himself and admired his beauty. And made two important decisions of his life that he would grow a mustache and always keep a smile on his face.
Okay. So, and what kind of, you can say, what kind of thoughts that comes into his mind when he was, when the snake coiled around his arm?
When the snake was coiled around. Around his arm, he smiled feebly.
It was the only life flashing. Okay, and ultimately, what was that? He was thinking that he has been, what he has been, that he is facing death. Okay, because the snake was just 3 to 4 inches away from his face. So it was just because of that reason that his happiness, it has turned into sadness, fearfulness, and all his thoughts that he was earlier thinking that have turned out to be very fearful. Now next, we have to do, it's on book only, we have to do. The question is, here are some sentences from the text. Say which of them tell you that the author was afraid of the snake and was proud of his appearance or had a sense of humor and was no longer afraid of the snake. So you will tell side by side. I was turned to stone.
Was afraid of snake.
Was afraid of the snake.
I was no mere image cut in granite.
He was no longer afraid.
Was no longer afraid of the snake.
I was no longer, yes, he was not afraid of the snake. The arm was beginning to be drained of strength.
Was afraid of the snake.
Okay, right. I tried in my imagination to write in bright letters outside my little heart the words, oh God.
Was afraid of the snake.
Next. I looked into the mirror and smiled. It was an attractive smile.
Was proud of his appearance.
I was suddenly a man of flesh and blood.
He was no longer afraid of the snake.
I was, after all, a bachelor and a doctor too, on top of it.
Was proud of his appearance.
So, the fellow had such a sense of cleanliness. The rascal could have taken it and used it after washing it with soap or water. What he was talking about here? He was talking about what?
The thief who stole everything from his apartment.
That the thief, he was actually talking about the vest that he was wearing, which was not so white, right? And ultimately, he thought that the thief, he must have taken that also. So, what kind of expression it is?
Had a sense of humor.
Okay, right. Had a sense of humor. Was it trying to make an important decision about growing a mustache or using an eyeshadow, mascara, or wearing a vermilion spot on its forehead.
Had a sense of humor.
What he was talking about at that point? He was talking about
snake.
The snake.
Admiring its beauty.
About snake. Okay, he was talking about snake. Next. Expressions used to show fear. So I was turned
to stone.
Into stone.
Okay, I sat there holding
my breath.
Okay, let
breath.
Enter the student. Just entered. So next, in the light of the lamp, I sat there like a stone image in the flesh. Image in the flesh. So next, let us do. In the sentences given below, some words and expressions are italicized, and they are variously mean that one is very frightened, is too scared to move, is frightened by something that happens suddenly, makes another feel frightened. So now match the meanings of the words and expressions in italics and write the appropriate meaning next to the sentence. So I knew a man was following me. I was scared out of my wits. It means very frightened, like they have written. Second one, I got a fright. What it means? I got a fright. What it means? It again means very frightened or frightened by something. Next, he merely jumped out of his skin when he saw the bull coming towards him. Jumped out of his...
Frightened by.
It means...
Is frightened by something that happens suddenly.
It means very frightened, actually. Okay. Next, you really gave me a fright when you crept up behind me like that.
Makes another feel frightened.
Frightened by something that happens suddenly. Next, afterwards. Wait until I tell this story. It will make your hair stand on end.
Makes another feel frightened.
Frightened.
Paralyzed with fear, the boy faced his abductors.
Frightened.
Too scared to move.
Right. It is too scared to move, because paralyzed means when you are unable to move. So it is right that it is unable to move. Next. The boy hid behind the door, not moving a muscle.
Too scared to move.
Right. So it is again too scared to move. So finally, we have done with that back exercise. Now coming up to the some of the questions that you have to write in your notebook. So let me announce here for your knowledge that for part one, question number 1, 2, 3, you will do in notebook. Okay. So now next, I'm writing some of the questions in order to discuss, to have a wide view of the chapter, so that you can write some of them in your notebooks, right? Write down the first question. Describe the authors. Rented residence. Describe the author's rented residence. Yes, who will speak?
The narrator was not a wealthy man. He was still at his starting point of his career. He had to work really hard to make ends meet. His apartment was not the best. The house was not electrified. It was a small rented room. He only had some shirts and some dhotis, and possessed one solitary black coat, which he was always wearing.
Yes, it was not electrified. Also, he was living in a single room, which was a rented room. It was not at all electrified, and the there were not enough furniture for him to sit. There was just one table and a chair which he is using for his dressing purpose also, and moreover he is also using it to study. Okay, when he was feeling not feeling to get fresh air outside, he came to sat there onto the chair, and in front of it the mirror was lying, and at that moment the snake or the cobra, it wriggled around its body. So next question, what was the doctor's choice for his marriage? What was
doctor wanted to get married with a woman doctor who had plenty of money and good medical practice.
Okay,
she had to be fat.
She is to him,
and she had and he had valid reason for it, because she made some silly mistake and needed to run away. She should not be able to run after him and can catch him easily.
And catch him, but ultimately, what has happened?
He ended up marrying a thin
woman. Okay,
thin, greedy person.
Running. So how can we say that? That the doctor was admirer of beauty. How can we say that the doctor was an admirer of beauty? How can we say that?
He used to look at his face in the mirror and made important decision that he would shave daily and grow a thin mustache to look more handsome. After all, he was a bachelor and a doctor. He smiled attractive so that he would look great. And
he felt that he had to make his presence.
He was admiring his good looks, first of all. Okay, those different points you have spoken. And moreover, when the snake was in front of the mirror, he was also, you can say, filled with fear. Okay, he was paralyzed with fear. He was not able to move. He was not at all a body of flesh and blood. But ultimately, at that moment, his humorous mind was working upon, and he was thinking of the beauty of the snake also, how the snake is looking into the mirror in order to enhance its beauty. Okay, so if I talk about what are the various humorous incidents, humorous, or how the narrator has added humor in the chapter, humor first, the way he opened up his book and ended up in what?
Ended up in admiring.
Yes, himself. He ended up in admiring his beauty. Then afterwards, like when he got humor, three main decisions. Okay, then also that he will wear a mustache. Okay, and what he will do?
Always have a smile on his face.
Then afterwards, next humorous incident, his wish to get married. And ultimately, what it ended up, this we have repeated a number of times. Okay, so this is again an example of irony here. Means what is meant and what has happened actually, right? Then when the snake, it coiled in front of the mirror, and how the narrator, he was looking at the snake. What he was looking at the snake at that time, that the snake was again admiring its beauty, sitting in front of the mirror. What it was doing, it was
admiring itself, thinking that he should make some changes to improve its beauty.
Right. Okay, that he should wear mascara, eyeliner, or a vermilion spot on its forehead.
Forehead.
So these are some of the humorous incidents. And last, remember the last one, when his house was evacuated, or it was, you can say, robbed by the thieves. And ultimately, of course, he was filled with sorrow because of the loss of the things, as he was not having too many things in his house. What he said, that the rascal had sense of cleanliness, that he has not taken his vest. This was again what? This is again an example of humor added up here. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Why did the doctor go back to his room in the morning? Why did the doctor go back to his room in the morning? Why he had gone back to his room in the morning?
To shift out of the place with help of his friends, because he had grown a fear of snakes and could not live there anymore.
No. Why he has gone back into his room the next morning? He has gone because he wanted, whether the snake had gone out of its place or not, he wanted to take away all the things so that he could shift to some other place. Right? He has gone with his friend and one or two other men in order to shift the belongings. But ultimately, to his surprise, what has happened? To his surprise, his house has already been robbed off by the thieves. When the narrator felt like an image cut in granite. When did the narrator feel like that an image cut in granite? Yes. When he felt so that he was like an image cut in granite.
When he felt a snake coiled around his left arm. He could not move a muscle, for the snake was only 4 inches away. The fear of being dead paralyzed him.
He was paralyzed, without any movement. And at that moment, what he thought, that he was an image cut in granite. Okay, so that's all for today with their discussion of these question answers. Tomorrow we will start with the writing skill. Okay, letter for placing an order. So get equipped with your notebooks tomorrow. Now let me take your attendance.